Good morning, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us. I'm John Levin, the Dean of the Stanford Graduate School of Business, and I'll be moderating today's session of our four-part symposium series with Stanford Medicine, The Pandemic Puzzle, Lessons from COVID-19. As a reminder, the goal of this series is to proactively identify lessons from the pandemic response across the government, the economy, and the healthcare system, both in the US and globally. By applying lessons from the recent past, we hope to better inform the current recovery from COVID-19 and our preparedness for future pandemics. Today's session is focused on the recovery. Specifically, how can we assure a more inclusive recovery going forward and in the future? Over the course of the pandemic, we have seen staggering disparities across populations, both within this country, people of low income, other vulnerable groups, and around the world. So as we respond and rebuild, it's critical that we understand the needs of different populations and the way the pandemic has impacted them so that recovery does not leave anyone behind. And we have some wonderful guest speakers today who have experience leading economic and health equity initiatives on the front lines of the COVID-19 response. They'll be speaking with professors from the Stanford School of Medicine and the Graduate School of Business and exploring how pandemic planning can better address issues of access, of equity, of community health locally and internationally. So I'm delighted that we're all taking time from our busy day-to-day schedules to dig deep into these pressing issues and to propose innovative solutions for the future. Before we dive in, I'd like to introduce my co-host, Dr. Lloyd Minor, the Dean of the Stanford School of Medicine. Lloyd, over to you.
Thank you very much. Good morning, John. And I'd like to join you in thanking everyone who has joined us today for this second in the four-part series on the pandemic puzzle. Without question, inequity in health and healthcare is one of the most pressing challenges in society today. It's a sad fact in America that the best predictor of life expectancy is not genetic code, it's the zip code in which a person lives. And COVID-19 has served as a stark reminder of the disastrous effects of these inequities and disparities in health and healthcare. Black and Latinx Americans are three times more likely than white Americans to get COVID-19 and two times more likely to die. And although the vaccines were developed quickly and deployed quickly and safely in America, there have been disparities both in the distribution of vaccines and also in the educational opportunities related to vaccines. And of course, long before COVID-19, we are very much aware of the disparities that have existed in terms of chronic diseases, the management of chronic diseases, the effects of chronic diseases on vulnerable and marginalized populations. I think we can all wish for, hope for, and strive to achieve a more equitable and inclusive health and healthcare system in the United States based upon what we've learned and what we've seen during COVID-19. But we know that this won't happen simply by chance. We know that if we are to create a more equitable environment for health and healthcare in America, it requires planning and intentionality. And our speakers and panelists today will explore these topics and share their expertise and their wisdom with us. Certainly for those of us in healthcare, there's no better place than the United States for the treatment of severe acute diseases. And so many advances in biomedical technology and medical technology have originated from the healthcare delivery system, from academic medical centers, from industries that have arisen around research and care delivery in the United States. And yet, to address the challenges of inequity and health disparities, we've got to think beyond our traditional approaches on after the fact approaches to treatments and cures. we've got to think to the root cause of many of the diseases that our ultra-specialized therapies are intended to address. Although all too often, these ultra-specialized therapies and approaches occur too late and are not equitably distributed. But to have the type of impact we know we can and must have on disparities, we have to look beyond the acute disease. We have to look at the underlying factors in society that lead to development of disease in the first place. And this, I believe, involves broadening our lens, our aperture, on what our responsibilities in health and healthcare are. And many of the experts who will be speaking with us today have thoughts and insights on how we can do that.